Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 44 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 77 questions in previous videos. Question number 78. You have an Azure load balancer named LB1. You assign a user named User1 the role shown in following exhibit. So user one has these role assigned, and roles are like this: that user access administrator role is assigned to user one on the LB1, so on this resource, and virtual machine contributor role is assigned on the resource group itself. Let's scroll down to answer area. So here we have statement given in answer area. User one can do to LB1, and what user one can do to the resource group. Before we answer this question, let's understand what user access administrator can do and what virtual machine contributor can do. User access administrator role. This role lets us assign or manage user access to Azure resource. So to any user we can assign the access to particular resource or revoke the access to particular resource. This is what we can do through the user access administrator role. Next one is virtual machine contributor role. By this we can create and manage virtual machines. Means we can create, edit, delete the virtual machines. We can manage disk of virtual machine. We can install and run software. We can reset the password of root user of virtual machine using VM extensions. That is also doable. Manage local user account using VM extensions. So we can almost do everything to the virtual machine as a virtual machine contributor. This role does not grant you the management access to the virtual network, so keep in mind the virtual machine contributor does not grant you the access to virtual network or storage account the virtual machine are connected to. So this role is limited to virtual machine only. This role does not allow you to assign roles in RBAC also. So that is definitely owner and user access administrator, they can assign the role to users. Back to our question. So in answer we can see now the user one, what user one can do on the load balancer one. Can we delete it? Definitely not, because we have user access administrator role on the load balancer one. Therefore we cannot delete it, and we can create net role also. We cannot create any net role over this, because these both cannot be done on this by the user access administrator. User access administrator only and only can do is that assign access to other users for this resource. So the last one is correct, because there is no other things other than that user access administrator can do on load balancer one. Next one is user one can on the resource group. So on the resource group we can manage the virtual machines, but here let's see what are the options given. Delete virtual machine from, yes, definitely we can do this, because in managing the virtual machine we can delete or create or edit the virtual machine. Modify the load balancing rules in, so we cannot definitely modify any load balancing rule, because we have no rights over the load balancer to change any rule. The last one is deploy Azure Kubernetes service. That is also, we do not have any rights on that. So the first statement is correct, which is the delete a virtual machine from the resource. So we can delete a virtual machine from resource group. Question number 79. You configure the custom role in following exhibit. So what is the role about? See, it's role 1 is given, role type is true. Okay, assignable scope. This role is implemented on this scope. The scope is subscription. The number is given for the subscription, and the permissions we will go through. I'll quickly scroll. These are the actions given here. We can go through this, and next there is no not action are not given anything. Data action are empty, and not data action as well empty. Further scroll down to answer area. Okay, in answer area, to ensure that users can sign into virtual machine that assigned role 1, modify the answer choice. So we have to select one of these option which can enable us to make the user sign in to the virtual machine. And the next statement is to ensure that role 1 can assign only to the resource group named resource group 1. So we need to change the assignable area. So this one is very easy to answer, that if we change the scope, because the scope was on subscription, which is larger area, but we want to limit it to resource group. So we can assign it to resource group, and we can make the change in assignable scope. Let's see this one. Definitely user can sign into virtual machine. That is not an action. There are called actions, but actions are something to do with the virtual machine itself. We are not going to do anything with virtual machine. That's why this is not applicable. It has nothing to do with the role type as well. It has nothing to do with not action, which are, since we are going to work into the resource itself, like logging in or any modification inside the virtual machine is called data action. So this is the correct answer. That's also definitely not correct answers. So data answer is the correct one in this case. Further, as per learn.microsoft.com, these are the data actions available over the virtual machine. So either we can log in. This is one of the action available. As a regular user, we can log in into virtual machine. Either this one we can select to log in into virtual machine, or if we would like to log in as administrator or Windows or Linux root user, we can have this data action in place. Log into Azure ARC machine, that is also available here. So these are the only data action we have available for the virtual machine. So I think this one could be applicable, and this could be applicable. Therefore, the answer to first statement is data action, and definitely second statement is assignable scope. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and press the bell notification icon to receive the notification. Share with your friends. Thank you for watching, and see you in next video.